Hi everyone, a very good evening to all of you and welcome on NaziesLakshmi.co where Lakshmi is the National Beauty Pageant winner, young corporate leader, TED speaker, Vice President IndieWood, Billionaires Club, Lakshmi Atul. So let's all welcome Lakshmi today.
Hi everyone. Thank you so much
for having me on board. Pleasure and honor and a warm welcome on NaziesLakshmi.co. Before we go ahead with the show, I would just brief the audience a bit about you and then we'll come back on the question answers and all that we would like to know about you. So guys, Lakshmi is a beauty, talent, intelligence and compassion personifies the adjectives about Lakshmi, perfectly maintaining an absolute balance between personal and professional life, a second rank holder for BTech in civil engineering and gold medal winner for MTech in traffic engineering and transportation planning, vice president of Aries Group companies, more than 12 years experience in a multinational consortium of 53 companies, projects in 16 countries. The Aries Group, and she's a model, anchor, and she has been a part of many ramp shows and fashion shows. So she is a fine amalgamation of success and power, beauty with purpose. An Indian queen of substance, face of South, and Mrs. Intelligent. She is one among five women who hold the esteemed ASNT Level 3 certificate in India. In addition to the other portfolios, she's also the head of Oscar Awards Consulting and the Film Festival Promotion Divisions and is often connoted as the rising star of Aries Group of Companies. So she's made India proud by winning Mrs. Grand Prix 2018 at the Royal Finals at Jamaica. Lakshmi had represented India as Mrs. India Charity 2018 at several projects for beauty, for charity functions in association with United Nations pageants. And she holds many awards and accolades. So we are really honored to have you here today with us, Lakshmi, and would love to know your journey and your story as an international beauty pageant winner, as a young corporate leader, vice president for Aries Group, IndieWood Billionaire Club. So we would love to know all that about your personal and professional journey from you, Lakshmi.
Thank you so much. Most of the things which I have to tell you covered right now are my journey. I'm basically from Kerala. I'm settled down in Cochin. I work as a vice. It's been my 14th year in the series. We are a consortium of almost like 53 companies in 17 countries. I take care of the India operations of IndieWood, which is basically an investment platform wherein we bring in investments to India. It's a huge project, it's a US dollar 10 billion project, bringing in investments in India. So I take care of the business part. On the personal side, I am a mother of a 12-year-old girl. I'm married for 14 years and living in Kochi. I've done my master's in traffic engineering and transportation planning, so National Institute of Technology. I worked once for civil service as well. So like I have tried civil service for three times and. Two times I've been lucky to be a part of this interview and unfortunately I couldn't be a part of the service, but still that has actually helped me a lot in making what I'm doing. And I thank all of my parents, my relatives, my friends, my colleagues, everyone around me who have actually helped me to see what I'm doing. I'm thankful to God, of course, for giving me such a wonderful life. Yeah, that's it.
Beautiful, awesome, lovely. And I think the audience is highly impressed with your profile and your introduction. And they're saying salute to you and you make our country proud. So Lakshmi, I would like to ask you, that. Can you tell us something about the struggles of being a woman in a corporate environment when you go down to the ladder?
Yes. So I was, I'm basically an engineer by profession, and I've chosen to be part of AB Group as a management trainee. So as you write up your ladder, write up your dedication, there has been a lot of things. Maintaining a career life balance, maintaining a personal versus social life, and being a woman, you face a lot of hurdles in terms of traveling, in terms of time you should actually get opportunity to work. But fortunately, I am with a team who has got a lot of support in terms of women empowerment, and all my colleagues support me towards in my journey, in what I am today.
So there were a lot of hurdles in terms of time management and a lot of stress when you handle things. But the environment here was like very, pretty supportive to all these female employees. And being a female team, I could actually get all the support from my male colleagues in my company.
Very nice.
And especially with respect to, as you mentioned, this ASNP 11 seat, predominantly people, it's male-dominated examination, wherein you have to get into the ship and do the surveying and get the reports done and all. So it's basically a male-dominated society, but a group, but still, I have got a chance. The company has asked me to write the exam, and I have got a chance to be in the front line, and I still lead as a front line member of the AVIS group, thanks to the AVIS family for the wonderful support I've been getting here.
Great, wonderful. So I think it gets it a little easier for women if you get good team support, as well as the company is there to give you all the support that is required for a woman to sustain in a corporate world.
True. As a woman, many times with a kid in your house and all, we need some flexibility, we need some support.
True.
So I have definitely got all that, and that's why I'm here.
Okay. Yeah, so like flexi hours and work from home, probably that is also being encouraged from the company sometimes when it is required. Great.
Definitely.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Wonderful. And as you just mentioned that you have a little child at home, so how do you juggle having a child and ensuring performance, like work-life balance? How do you manage that so beautifully?
It's pretty difficult, but still, whatever time I get, I make sure that I have my daughter's participation as well, like in terms of the time which I allocate for my fitness, which I allocate for my reading, the movies, everything, the time, whatever I get outside my office hours, I make sure that I have her as a company. So that's how I work on it. And definitely in the video course, she'll also be independent, because my mom was a working woman, and I have been very independent as she was independent. So I was like, she is also getting trained as an independent, strong woman who can actually take care of the future. So I make sure that, whatever time I go cooking, or I go for reading, I go for walk, I go for run or fitness or gym or anything, I make sure she also comes with me, she joins me, so that we get enough time.
Yes. Oh, nice. And do you feel that women are better at multitasking, just as in the corporates there are more men, but do you think that women are better at multitasking? And I'm so glad that you're already training your daughter how to know to multitask, and you are a live example in front of her, same as you learned it from your mom. So it's amazing, and I think we all should learn from you, and you are the role model probably.
Definitely, I feel like multitasking is one of the aspects which you should definitely try. Not that I make sure that I make a priority list, definitely, of the things which I should focus on. And definitely multitask, not that lot of activities, but focus one at a time. And I have, as a woman, definitely you have to have your family, you have to have your work life, you have to have your kids. So this is definitely multitasking. You are doing different, you're taking roles of different people. And so, but then I focus whenever you are at office, you make sure that you concentrate on your office work, and that's a priority. When you are at home, make sure that you keep your time to your family. So that multitasking definitely is there, but still I make sure that it's based on prioritized things.
Right. True. And keep the focus, and then do full justice to whatever you're doing at that particular time. Yes. I believe that's important.
Yes, very important.
And Mr. Ibrahim is here. Hi, Mr. Ibrahim. And he's saying that you are the Die by Davies group of company.
thank you.
And Lakshmi, how you stood up to such sly remarks when you took up the challenge to study for this certification? If you can tell something about that.
Okay, so my company is basically, our company is the largest ship design and marine consultancy firm in Italy. So we were actually focused more on the marine aspect in 2011, and still now it's like it's a leading company in Italy. I was part of the media and energy division, and I always had the fire to learn or to accept challenges and get new opportunities. So there was an option of 2-3 people in our group who were asked to write this particular exam, and my CEO, he actually asked me whether I can take up this challenge. It's very difficult, but if you can take up this challenge, we'll be more than happy for you, he said. So I didn't have any prior experience of doing this, just that I was a part of some. So I said, I could actually get into the certification. And later on, I started training. We have got a research institute and started training people here. Yeah.
Wow. So really inspiring, and you know, to take up challenges and not fear it and just go and do it. So you kind of proved it for sure. And so what do you have to say that, you know, there are so many pressurizers, like you can't travel alone and be strong in meetings for women. So what do you have to say about that?
It's all about our perception and on how we think of it. When I started the journey of being the leader of any board and traveling for the marketing and events and everything, there was a start where people have actually said that you can't travel alone. Being a girl and to travel and everything. But I have always felt that this platform actually has, I could actually be the ambassador for the company. Well, thanks to the pages which have done and also the civil service background which have helped me. Rather than city, I was more of a research person. I would like to read and do research and all that thing. But then once I entered backgrounds, I could understand that there are lots more to do. That is, there are lots to be an ambassador for the women, actually. So, and as a woman, as a girl, you get a lot of opportunities, lot of exposure, and a lot of areas. We should be definitely careful about the security that is definitely there. But at the same time, it's all the perception, how strong and how confident you are in taking care of it. So I could actually manage, yeah. I could actually, there were a lot of issues initially in the sense I was I had a restriction, some distance, I couldn't travel and all that. But then after the events, meetings and all, I could actually manage it. And right now I'm very comfortable and very happy. And so for the people who would like to travel, definitely go ahead. Just make sure that you're safe and secure, and otherwise it's not, the world is really active, it's all the perception that matters.
True, very good message, and I can relate with you that when you are young, when you're beautiful, and you know, you have these insecurity that maybe is it right that I'm traveling alone, should I do it, should I not do it? But then over the period of time, when you start traveling, when you start interacting, and when you know how to handle people and how to be strong, then probably you are able to do it, and there is no harm. I think a lot of women should travel. They should explore the world, actually. But yeah, to be careful at the same time. And you know, pageants can be, like, you've also been a part of a lot of pageants, and you are have walked the ramp, and you made India proud. So, you know, these pageants can be linked as how one loses focus on personal development once you get immersed in the profession.
regard that you have these issues. So I always wanted to meet sometimes the representative of the women, basically. So, but in those times, we didn't have the option of a missing agent. And so, okay, definitely, I started my fitness journey and reduced to 60 kg. Like, it was sometimes it was like even I went down to just 50 kg, but then I then decided to maintain my weight. So I improved and maintaining her attitude. And then when I reached this point, I thought, like, why not? I'll try this. That was always my my wish that to represent or how does it, I just wanted to be, understand. I just want to get a feel of what I missed in my childhood. But luckily, there was this, I was just finishing my civil services, and I just got an invitation in Facebook to be the representative of Mrs. Kerala. And I thought I'd just give it a try, and I went for Mrs. Kerala, and I was the finalist, and I couldn't perform much because I didn't have the experience, and I couldn't perform much, but still I was very confident. I thought, okay, I've got the taste of agent, so I'm done with it. But what happened was that later on in 2 months, I got called from Business India to be a part of Business India. So I thought, okay, I'll represent Kerala and be a part of Business India. I went there. So I'm not a person who knows ramp walk well. I'm like a very confident girl, but not Asian fashion. I don't know much about dressing or styling or anything like that. But the corporate service background has definitely helped me talking and presenting and all that. So that was that was my strength. So I worked more on my strength rather than my weakness. But still, I managed to walk the ramp and dress like a model and all. But I just wanted to see. Whenever I was doing this, I wanted to prove my fellow women that nothing is impossible. You can definitely do it. Whatever you want to do, if you have a dream, you can definitely do it. I'm 5'4", and I'm much. So it is always, people always think about when the modeling as the area where you should be very tall, very slim. And so I just wanted to let them know that it's not about being very small or very tall or everything, nothing like that. It's all your confidence that matters. And there are very any nice number of other opportunities, even if you are short or slim or fat or anything like that, or like bulky or skinny or anything. So you have got any number of opportunities. Just that you have to identify that and get into that. So I just wanted to prove that.
Very nice.
And then
That's
why I got opportunity for the next Mrs. United Nations that was in Jamaica. And that is really challenging, competing with almost 70 countries, and that's really challenging. And but then the experience I've got from Jamaica was really good in terms of my fellow contestants, the time I have spent with them, the activities, the food, the culture, everything. It was very different, and I was very happy being a part of the pageant and representing India.
It's commendable, I must say, and very inspiring, all that you said right now, to the people who want to contest for all these contests. And also, you're right that, you know, if you're slim, you are maintained, and you have more confidence for sure, and that helps you build up your confidence, and you did work hard for it, and nothing is impossible. I think once you decide for something, you can lose weight, and you can look more beautiful, more confident, and it's commendable. So you took up challenges every year to ensure personal growth, started with civils, the pageants, the gym, etc. As someone who came through the ranks of corporate, starting off as a trainee, PG trainee, and now reaching the post of vice president in 10 years. So how has that journey been, the experience?
As I said, I was very lucky to be a part of the agency group. Definitely the support of my management, my colleagues, that is definitely there. And also this is like how you take up the opportunity. Like you can, as I said, I was a management trainee. I was taking care of the research and the development. So as I was going in the company,
make sure that I upgrade myself. I acquire more knowledge. I started learning myself from like the certification course I said, and also whatever that comes in. Oh, I make sure that I learn, and the company definitely supports learning. We get training every now and then. So, and if you have an option, if you want to, right now I'm doing a brand management course with London School of Economics. And it's definitely helping me, and that is one thing which actually has helped me. And also, when it comes, when an opportunity comes in, like say a marketing opportunity comes in, or a different project is being planned by the company, I make sure that I have some participation there. And if that is something challenging, I'll definitely take care of it, and I move ahead with that. So that is how that's the journey of being from the management trainee to what I am today. So I've been doing the post-production, editing, videos and dubbing. I've done answering a lot of shows I've hosted. Then I have done the research and development. Also, we have the Oscar consultancy, where we are the only Oscar consultancy in the Asia, which actually takes movies from India to Oscar. So we execute the Oscar. Yeah. We also have the film festival consultancy. So we are now right now with the film, Hollywood film carnival. We have done 5 major events in Hyderabad and Kerala, which is actually almost 20,000 to 30,000 delegates coming in for the particular event in 5 days. So handling that event, So it's all about how you utilize the opportunities that the environment gives you. I mean, this particular area has given me a lot of opportunities, and I could be a part of all the major projects here.
I think you were fortunate to be at the right place at the right time, and also you are a learner, so that I think really matters. And there's a fire in the belly to learn, to grow, so then you definitely reach where you want to, you know, reach and do what you want to do. And I think there is there's a comment by Jasleen. So she's saying that even slim girls have a complex. So what do you have to say about that?
I don't believe in being slim or being fat or nothing. It's basically being confident and being fit. So as and when you're healthy and fit, you're okay. I mean, love your body, love yourself. So as a person, I have always loved my body. When even like sometimes I say that I miss my 100 kg body. But if you're confident enough, you're in a body. No, it doesn't matter what shape or what size you are. What matters is how confident you are. I mean, be happy with what you have, but make sure that you're healthy. That's definitely the
right.
I was unhealthy. I was unhealthy at that point when my cholesterol levels were increasing. I was feeling a bit uncomfortable when like walking with others. I had this problem of you have breathing difficulty and walking fast and all that. So I just wanted on a healthier side, if you can work on your health, that definitely matters. On the other side, if you're very confident on you and you're healthy, and whatever size or shape you have doesn't matter, so be confident. You are unique in your that's your friend.
True. Very well said. Because actually all the health issues start from weight problems, actually, I believe. And it's more important to be healthy than to be thin or fat, actually. That's true. And well said. And you know, doing something you've never done before, does that help you learn things in a new light?
Definitely. That is what I always do. So as I said, being an academic, a bookworm, I always say that I was a bookworm. I was very active in sports when I was a kid, like 6, 7 standard. I was very active, and sometimes from a very conservative family, wherein my dad said, okay, you're 13 years old, you're not supposed to play with boys right now, you go and study.
Okay.
So this is the, you definitely get those words. So I thought okay, I'll just stop everything, I'll just start studying, and I started studying, focusing more onto my books and reading and all that.
Academics.
And then I started, I was completely a book for, did my engineering, did my PG and everywhere. No, I scored high, and I was really into the academy. And as soon as I got married, I also decided I will reduce my weight. My in-laws were very supportive. They were very health conscious. So they were very supportive as well. So they also wanted they accepted me as a sad girl. But then they actually said, okay, on the health side, if you remove, that's good for you. So definitely. Actually, I understood that, and I started learning different things, like I made sure that I walk wherever I go. Bike or anything like that, and make sure I walk, because you don't find time, you know? So the only thing you can do is you can make it as a part of your lifestyle, then only you can take it forward. If you consider it as a burden, it is like, oh my god, I can't do this today, I don't have time, all that. But then if you have time for watching TV, if you have time for having food and brushing your teeth, cleaning yourself, you definitely have time for fitness also. So I then fitness came into my mind. That was not completely, that was nothing related to what I have been doing in my life. But then fitness came in, and through fitness, I could understand, I could realize that you should definitely take up challenges and move ahead in life. So I started learning different things, different aspects. So I went for cycling. I was a mountaineer. I was like, I've cycled for like 200 kilometers in a stretch for like in Salwa's time. And I've been to marathon, half marathon. Tried different things. And whatever that is best for me, I definitely incorporate that in my life. And sometimes some of the things may not be like as good as you think. And definitely, but you should understand, you should taste everything, no? So I just taste everything, whatever is good for me, whatever I feel comfortable, I take it with me, other things I just leave it. But I'll definitely try everything, boxing, everything, fit, gym, fitness, dance, zumba, everything.
Lovely. I think it's very inspiring for everybody who's hearing the conversation today. And it's all about mindset, you know, as you said, that if you have time to brush your teeth, take a shower, that same way you should just have time for your fitness as well. Every day you should include it. And all that you're saying is actually so inspiring. And what would be your advice to upcoming women management trainees who are joining corporates?
That you have to be confident on yourself. You are unique, and girls have got a very high chances of performing better than men. I mean, from my experience, at least in our company, as well as my friends, all of them are performing really well. So there is always, we are born with a talent of athletes and multitasking. You have got the task, and you always have the capability of pleasing others. You talk very well, you meet others, you have good communication skills, you have good PR skills, you have you know how to execute things, you have time management. All those are much needed in a software area. So you just have to be confident. You may have to see some hurdles in your life, that is definitely there, but be positive, be focused, and confident. I think definitely we can move ahead.
That's very nice. Yeah, because I think we are all born naturally with all these multitasking activities. We can multitask very well, and one has to be like really confident and positive. For the newcomers, a great suggestion by Lakshmi. And if I may ask you, Lakshmi, what has been the biggest lesson you have learned from your life?
I lost my father when I was 18. That was the biggest thought I have got ever. I have never thought that I would ever be able to overcome that and be what I am today. But the thing I have found that we should go on, whatever we are facing is, go on and go ahead. Every single minute is valuable for us. Even when we see the COVID situation and everything happening around us, every minute is valuable. Every minute of life is valuable. And just move on. Whatever happens to your life, that happens. And you can't help with your past, but be the best and get ready for the future.
These are the hard realities of life that one has to accept and move on. But we cannot help. And you rightly said that you have to come out of it and move on.
You can take your time. You can take your time. You can relax. You can take your time. Understand the situation. But then you have to move on. Your family, your friends, your society, and everyone, you have to move on.
Lakshmi, I believe you took almost a year off your work to prepare for civil services exams. What motivated you to that decision?
I always had the dream of civil services, and I always wanted to be a civil servant. There was a time when my company have a theater, small theater in our office, there is very motivation videos every day. So there was one day when a motivation video came and I was feeling really bad from inside. I don't know what happened. I was thinking, what has made me so bad? That was that movie, that video was on passion and how to chase your passion to your dreams and it. So I was discussing this with my senior, which is our director. So I was asked to talk to me and I said, I always have this dream of doing something. But then unfortunately, see, I was 29 then. So I said that I'm 29 and there is only one more chance left for me. So he said, stop right now. You go and register in academy and write that exam and then come back. So I said, sister, with the family and everything, I don't think I can do that. He said, no, you can still do that. Just try that. And if you're not able to do it, come back. That's fine. If you're able to do it, go ahead. So with those words, I joined an academy and wrote a service for that. And then I came here that year. So okay. I would hear that, yeah. But then I was like, okay, fine, I'm done. There's a free to do that, I'm very happy.
Yeah.
But then what happened is that they got two extensions, like 2 years extra exemption that year, 2014. The who was the previous year. Luckily,
okay.
So I said, okay, this time I take leave and prepare well. And then just 2 years, no? So I stayed. There also, fortunately, my company said, okay, go for a long leave. So I think 6 months late, I wrote a film and I was really not confident. I was working part-time. Also, my kids was growing up with 7 years, so it was growing up.
Okay.
And this is the academy, a lot of things to read. I was really not confident, but then once I started reading, it actually helped me. So I made it part of my life. Every time you read, you understand particular things, you develop an opinion, so that you don't have to put in extra pressure in studying. So so that was there, and I could luckily have friends there also, who could actually help me out with the notes and everything. So, and I wrote at the conferences, and I got names, and I really shocked the first time, because that was my first experience, and I could really go to the interview. No, that was really a surprise for me as well, but I could actually be a part of the interview. So unfortunately that year I could actually miss for my cutoff was, I got 9 marks short of the cutoff. So
okay.
I unfortunately missed through that year.
Oh.
But it was like, and it has definitely molded me in what I am doing. They have got opinion in everything. You need a particular thing, you need to develop your own experience, not just what others do. So that is definitely helping what I am doing. So being from an interview culture, someone who is a bookworm, this services interview and this services research has helped me change the seasons and then different corporate ladder and seeing what I am doing.
Very nice, because nothing goes waste, especially education. You know, I feel personally it never goes waste, and I don't know how much you're inspiring today, because every incident I'm listening, I'm getting inspired myself. Commendable and kudos to you. So you are an inspiration for many, I'm sure. And how do you think participating in beauty pageants enriched your life?
Yeah, as I said, I always had it, but I was never really confident on being a beauty pageant, and enriching my life in terms of I have been an inspiration to many women throughout the world, and I've been talking to many women and who are homeless, who feel down, who were very active before marriage, and who didn't do anything after that. They just take care of the household and they feel that they're children, they don't know what to do and all that. I'm very happy being a part of them and supporting them, and to find a way to go ahead in their lives and focus one at a time so that they develop themselves. And it's basically the inspiration I could actually give to my fellow women. I think five people very close to me. I could mentor them and be a part of theirs. That's really happy. So it's not about the crowd which you have, but then the acceptance, the support I could actually give them, that makes me really happy.
Right. because with your experience and you yourself experiencing all that, it's easier for you to mentor many more people who are going through the same thing. And and Lakshmi, what would you prefer, hard work or smart work?
I would prefer smart work because I am always a person who does smart work. Even as I said, I was doing my work and doing taking care of my family, not that I was reading, interesting and doing my civil service. I actually wanted a booster, even if I don't get to civil service, I actually wanted to be in my office. I wanted to be happy with my family. So it's all in smart work. If you work in this case, you can put 2 hours of your time, you can put 3 hours of your time. I'm not saying that if you shouldn't be a hard working person, you should definitely work hard. But smart work definitely
plays
a major role. I would prefer smart work.
True, absolutely. And it does also require hard work, but maybe the hours are not the same, you know. It may require less of hours of hard work, but then smart work is always better over hard work. I agree with you on that. Could you please share your experience being part of a multicultural international competition such as Mrs. United Nations?
So Mrs. India, it was open for me. I was competing. I know what India is and what our people are and how to interact with them and everything. But Mrs. India, United Nations was a big change for me. I could actually, the moment I landed in Jamaica, things were completely different. I mean, it was like really hard for me. It was 10 days program. It was really hard for me to to be liked there over there. It is not a very safe country. So you were completely in the you were not supposed to go and roam around and nothing like that. Okay. And I was placed in an obvious and so their nature is completely different from ours and there was a high
cultural difference also.
The competition was very high in terms of they were like the moments there is they would even make your feelings that hiding somewhere and all that. At the same time, there was a lot of bonding and a lot of understanding and I could get a lot of sisters. And we would always say ourselves, we call ourselves sister, sisterhood. A lot of sisters aspects from the and being someone in the corporate world, this region has actually helped me in getting representatives in all the countries. It's the selection, it's the branding which I could actually get from these students. So as someone coming from the I would consider that as a branding exercise. In branding myself as a person, I have got a lot of selections in all the countries. I need some support in some countries. I can definitely give a call to a particular person who you are in Singapore, how are you doing? And I have to help. So it is like speaking my speech. And
and you get globally connected closely with the other people from different countries.
Yes, I think we are global citizens. Definitely helps me. Especially when we fly to Kerala flight comes in, I could raise the amount of money with of my sister,
as I said. So that's awesome. Yeah. Very nice. Awesome. And do you think corporate sectors really give importance to women's safety? As someone who manages a large team, how do you balance the work timings and load of subordinate with their safety, and both physical and mental?
Yes. As I said, my company, we work on the women's safety and we take care of the women and activities. We've got a cell for the women's prevention. We address the issues. We have meetings every now and then. Some issues are formed up. Definitely, the women's safety is a concern here. We train women. We have a few sessions. We conduct sessions for training women. The desirers and the team people, the adopt people, the business, everything. You know, every aspect of their life. Also, we have a safety culture here. There is some of the women and find it difficult to cope up with the time and work from home, or get work, or it's just that they have to complete the work and but then you get flexibility and support from the company. You need some agility, everything. So that is definitely there. So definitely, as I said, I was one of the beginners. First set of ladies who have come in this room, and I still am very happy that I could see the team. There are a pretty number of girls right now with us. We're very happy and as well.
Yeah, so you're a live example for them, and also like anybody who's joining, so they don't have to really worry about their safety or about, you know, the timing, work timing issues and all that, because the company takes good care of them. And what about the mental safety or the mental, you know, security of the working people over there, conferences?
Yeah, as I said, we take care of the, give them sessions, like there are trainers coming here, we give them sessions on their mental health, physical health, the business aspect.
Okay.
We also have a health management system over here where it's properly take care of their health system as well. So it is being properly recorded everywhere, and whenever they find it difficult, so there is an our company is like, we have always had a connection with your CEO. Our CEO is accessible to everyone. So if you have an issue, you can definitely address the issue to him, and he's such a nice person. He definitely takes care of the issue. They find a way so that they can be comfortable mentally, physically, and
Right. And I believe the corporates are also organizing mental wellness, you know, seminars by these coaches who come and, you know, give them the coaching, how to handle the pressure, how to handle corporate culture and all that, right?
Yes. We have psychiatrists, psychologists, we have people coming in and giving sessions, and that also helps us out,
Yeah, and I'm really curious to know that would you consider not making it to the final list of the civil services to be a slight blemish in otherwise all-conquering career of yours? Because you tried hard, you know, did it at an age when even it is not allowed to appear for it, but because you had the passion, you had the desire to do it, it is so commendable, you worked hard for it. So do you think, since you have been, you know, winning everywhere and done exceptionally well when it came to anything, so what do you have to say for that?
It's not that everyone asks me this question, like, as a person who has always been successful, it's not that I have not been successful everywhere. I have tried all the options, I have failed many times, many places, and that's how, because I have not considered it as a failure. I feel that that has helped me in improving myself, upgrading myself, and making me a different direction altogether. So that has definitely helped me out, but that was my dream definitely, and my dream is to be once a part of the United Nations, which is a bigger aspect of civil service. So I'll definitely work towards being part of the United Nations, I hope, and as a bit, I lost nothing because of civil service. But then I got many, many exposure, a lot of connections, and see, right now, as well, I am civil service aspirant, I've got connections with all the districts, all the states. I've got friends working in the foreign services, ISS, IBS officers, IS officers, all those are connections for me, and so it's really helping me with my business actually. So it is definitely an add-on for me, a value addition for me in my life.
Very nice to know that, and your positive attitude definitely inspires, because instead of going in a shell and not feeling good about it all your life, it's a very good positive attitude, I must say, and people should really learn from your example, because you can do well in so many other fields which you have already proved. And if I may ask you, Lakshmi, the definition of luxury, since the program is about madhvisluxury.co, would like to know the definition of luxury according to you.
According to me, I don't prefer to be a luxurious person, but then luxury is something I would define it as something that is that makes you comfortable, that is a lifestyle that is supporting others in society and everything. I would be, whatever I have today, I feel I'm luxurious. It's not the high class lifestyle or anything which you call it as luxury. Whatever privilege you get, it, I can sit and talk to you, I have internet connection, I have phone, I have a family, I have good friends, I'm happy that that is more than luxury for me. So I would say that, and as someone who is in the Billionaires Club, we actually want more investments to come in India and boost our economy, get a lot of people and a lot of jobs. And so I would say that being a part of this is a luxury.
Right, absolutely, lovely. And if you can leave a bit about the Billionaire Club as well. I was keen to know about the Billionaire Club.
So Inuit Billionaires Club, as I said, Inuit was launched in 2015. It was a 5-year project.
Can you hear me?
Hello, yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Just for a second.
Indiewood was launched in 2015, which was actually a US dollar 10 billion project. It was to bring in investment in the entertainment and the elite sector, the entertainment media and elite sector. So the aim was, because our company, we have done a movie called Damn Triple Nine, that was in 2007, and we could take the movie everywhere, not just in India. We could take to all the film markets, we could take the movie to Oscars and all the major film festivals.
Wow.
We could actually prove ourselves to how a person or a company can be branded. So we actually wanted to pass on this message to every other people. And there are a lot of investors outside India who are ready to invest in cinema or the film sector, but then they're afraid because of a lot of the trade unionism, a lot of issues happening in India, a lot of structural differences. We've got a central government, we have a state government, you need to get a lot of permissions. Then we actually wanted to prove that we can do it. So that we started doing this Indiewood Film Carnival. First two event was in Kerala, second, third and fourth edition was in Ramoji Film City, and fourth was in Hyderabad Center in Hyderabad. And Hyderabad, Telangana was just formed. They wanted us to do this event in Telangana, and then we decided to do it in Hyderabad. And this was like the event wherein they could an investor will come to the event for 5 days, and that person can witness everything. He can witness movies, he can witness cinema business, he can witness talent, like there are talent hunt programs, he can witness awards, he can see celebrities, he can see the background work, he can see Ramoji Film City. It was like a holiday for them. It's like 5 days, they will know everything about cinema. And then, so in 2017, we brought in a lot of investors. We decided to launch the Hollywood Billionaires Club as a club wherein they can all come together. And if there are some good projects, we will definitely take it up and invest in that. And this project is like, right now we have close to 170 members in it, regional and international. And just that the COVID came up and we couldn't do much on the networking and events after March. But otherwise, we actually did our last event in Chennai, where we have got around 20 people joining us. So it's going day by day. We would like to be a platform where we could actually help India reach the vision, like our Prime Minister says, $1 is equal to 1 rupee. I don't know when that is going to happen, but still it's like what we wanted. We wanted to have more investment coming in India. So Indian products. We've got a lot of talents and everything with us, but then just that we went through the investment, the money, the push, the technology. We don't have, so we have to bring in that. So that is the
A wonderful concept and a project, I'm sure. And once things are better, it's going to go places for sure. And if I may ask you, Lakshmi, the message you would like to give to the audience on COVID-19?
See, COVID-19, we are all stressed out with lockdowns, with our business going down, many job cuts, all that issues. But what I would say is, whatever available with you, be productive and focus on your future. We'll also be able to overcome this crisis. We'll come back stronger. Just focus on yourself, your health, your mental health. Be with your family. You're finding time to spend with your family these days. So do that. Talk to them. Talk to your friends. You get a lot of time, but talk to your friends. Focus on what you like to do. If you like to sleep, you like to watch movies, do that. Whatever you like to do, that, so
well said. And it's been a real pleasure hosting a humble, positive soul like you. And you sure inspire. You make our country proud. And it's been amazing. Thank you so much, Lakshmi, for taking out your precious time and being with me here on madhvislakshmi.co.
Thank you so much. It was really a pleasure being a part of this show. Thank you so much. Usually I sit on the host side.
I'm honored. I'm really honored. Have a great evening. Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Bye. Bye. So for any of you who have missed the talk shows, can watch it on my YouTube, madhvisluxury.co, and the show is powered and supported by Padma Shri artist Krishna Kanhai ji, Sari Sanskriti by Salma Sultan, Nora USA by Aisha Khanna, and I feel proud to say that I'm associated with Trump Towers, Gurgaon. So any queries you have related to any of these luxury clients of mine, you're more than welcome to kind of get in touch with us. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.